My second question is, can the sponsor shed light to many of the concerns of all members, actually, both in the majority and the minority, regarding the tax compliance requirements of candidates for the barangay election? Could you shed some light on what really that is, the requirements, the paperwork, and why that was required by the COMELEC?
Mr. Speaker, Ms. Kulig, may I ask for what particular requirement are you referring?
The BIR requires, the BIR requires tax registration for candidates for the barangay election. I'm sure the COMELEC knows that. So what's the background of that? Did the COMELEC agree with the BIR that this is a requirement, as part of the requirement of becoming an official candidate? What's the process? So I think that's many members of the House, and actually the public, are interested what's really that tax registration is all about.
Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleague, with regards to that 500 peso requirement of the BIR, that's not within the jurisdiction of COMELEC. Hindi po siya requirement for the barangay candidate to file his candidacy. That requirement stems from the requirement to file SOSE. Lahat po ng kandidato nagpa-file ng SOSE. Under po the NIRC, meron pong requirement of registration. So, doon po ang BIR on their own implemented that requirement, because nakikita nila na at the end of the election period, everybody should file SOSE kasi nasa batas po ng Omnibus Election Code. So, with that, kailangan po sila mag-register with the COMELEC. So, yun po, yung 500 is a sort of registration lahat ng kandidato. Because the BIR is expecting na the candidates will receive financial donation from their supporters. Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleagues.
For the public who may be listening in to our deliberations, can the sponsor elaborate on the SOSE? I mean, we understand what that is, but for the people who are listening.
The SOSE is a statement of contribution and expenditure of each candidate in every election. So that is a requirement by the COMELEC that all candidates should file, whether barangay candidates or national level candidates. So if the candidate will not file, especially if they will forget to file twice, so they will be subject for disqualification in the succeeding election. Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleague.
And from what I recall, the SOSE, I think, has to be filed within 30 or 45 days after the election day?
Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleague, for barangay election purposes, within after 30 days.
Okay, 30
days. To clarify po, yung 500 peso requirement, hindi po requirement ng COMELEC. So it's the BIR on their own.
And does the COMELEC support the BIR requirement? Because that's burdensome. There are many SK members, candidates, who are students who have no income, and they're being required to pay 500 pesos. I can't recall, I think this is the first time it's being implemented. I didn't realize that an election period is a revenue generation activity for the national government. It's somewhat shameful, Mr. Sponsor. What are your thoughts on that?
Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleague, yes, the COMELEC do not agree with the BIR. No? Kasi it's really a financial burden on the part of the barangay, especially with the barangay candidates.
So, Mr. Speaker, thank you for that. Now, my understanding, when you file that statement of contributions and expenditure, it is not filed with the BIR, it's filed with the COMELEC. So, to connect the filing of the SOSE with the tax registration is really completely separate.
Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleague, the reason that there's a connection, because in the filing of SOSE, kailangan po mag-attach ng mga resibo. So yung resibo po galing po sa BIR. That's how to liquidate the donation. But the problem with yung presumption ng BIR doon sa donation, sa financial donation, pinapresume nila na subject to donor's tax, which in fact, hindi siya subject to donor's tax. Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleague.
Is the sponsor familiar with Article 5 of the Philippine Constitution, in particular Section 1, that refers to suffrage?
Yes po, Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Speaker, part of that Section 1 reads, no literacy, property, or other substantive requirement shall be imposed on the exercise of suffrage. Would the good sponsor agree with me that the tax registration and the 500 peso requirement may be a violation of Article 5, Section 1?
I agree po. The sponsor agrees. My distinguished colleague, Mr. Speaker.
Can we get the position of the COMELEC, having the sponsor already supported this representation's opinion on it, to come up with an action plan to deal with this issue?
Mr. Speaker, yes po, the COMELEC will come up with an action plan, because it's really not part, no, with the requirement of filing the candidacy. So, and it violates the section under Article 5 that you mentioned, distinguished colleague, Mr. Speaker.
Is there still a possibility, Mr. Speaker, that the COMELEC can come up with some sort of an issuance to make that BIR requirement not applicable for this upcoming barangay elections?
Mr. Speaker, senior colleague, yes po. The answer is yes. The COMELEC will come up with a resolution or a petition advisory, no, addressed to the BIR by tomorrow, Mr. Speaker, senior colleague.
Okay. Thank you very much. Many of the members are happy with the assurance and the commitment made by the good sponsor. I appreciate your support on that particular issue, and the clarification for the many concerns on social services. Thank you so much, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you po, Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleague.
Majority Floor Leader.